Hello everyone, Leon here. Today I want to discuss why knowledge is a very poor substitute to understanding. And why no matter how many things you think you know, how many theories you invent, and how many courses you purchase regarding how to set up a business, nothing will ever beat self-experimentation. Welcome back. Hello everyone, Leon Castillo here. I'm the CEO and founder of Self-Master, which is a company that specializes in peak cognitive performance for entrepreneurs and business leaders. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and let us know what you're struggling with, because this channel is to help you advance your career and scale your business at record speed. Our clients, in fact, told us their secret weapon. So today I want to discuss a phenomenon that I believe is pervasive in our culture, and is the excessive reliance on theory, on knowledge, as if that was an actual substitute to practice and experimentation. See, most business building coaches actually deliver step-by-step plans that you can take in order to achieve X result. The problem is that these courses rarely work, because the conditions which a business is built are dynamic, not static. So everything is changing all the time. Everything is in motion. And the tactics that you purchase in 2021 cannot be sold by someone that used that same tactics in 2017. The point here being is that there's no substitute to clarity, and clarity can only come through experimentation. Experimentation is the number one skill all entrepreneurs must cultivate if they want to win in the marketplace. Because remember that at Self-Master, we always see reality as a system. We're very big on complexity science. And the fundamental unit of analysis in complexity science is basically the system. So you got the input, you got the process, you got the output, you got the feedback, and of course, you got the environment, right? So input, process, output, feedback, and environment. No, that's feedback, sorry. Anyway, feedback, an environment. So if we think reality or a business or life as a system, we soon understand that the environment in which our life happens, our business performs, is always in motion. There's always dynamism that needs to be taken care of. And if you purchase something that is providing you like a step-by-step system, you're skipping the clarity that comes from trying a lot of things and in order to uncover the pattern that motivate the behavior of that environment. So my point here being is that it's way better to learn how to fish than be given a fish, right? And this is a fundamental analysis that Nassim Taleb, the econometrist, now turned philosopher, called the execution edge or the convexity bias. And it is well resuming the idea that Yogi Berra said that in theory, there's no difference between theory and practice, but in practice, that actually is, right? So no matter how well you study a subject, the realest data and the most insightful pieces of data will always come from being in the field of play, trying new thing, experimenting new thing, extracting cause-effect relationship that nobody else can extract because they're not doing the same experiments that you're doing. So this is a way of saying that you cannot solve your problems by thinking them through. At some point, you need to commit to a decision and actually go full on to try to prove it wrong. Not prove it right, but prove your hypothesis wrong, right? And without getting too technical, because this can get very technical, but Taleb proved that the execution edge is definitely real, right? So let's say that we are plotting a results curve here. Well, results curve that are due to pure luck, let's say we're trying to achieve A, luck will give us very low chance of results, right? It's not replicable, it's not process. Just operating on knowledge, right? Knowing a lot about a subject, but not iterating what we learn based on the feedback that the marketplace or the system provides, well then, that provides just a little edge over luck. But the real edge, the convexity bias, or the execution edge, as we call it in Submastered, actually comes from trying and experimenting. And over time, that difference is exponential because you're using feedback loops to refine your value proposition, to refine your market mechanism, to refine your business, to refine your own protocols. Nothing beats trying. And one of the most pervasive problems I see, especially in the younger generations, is thinking things too much. That's just a fancy way, especially if you're you have a high IQ, you're highly intellectual, that's a very fancy way of wasting time. That was my number one preferred way of wasting time, is just thinking things too hard without actually taking decision and acting on it, right? So I hope this makes sense. This is an absolutely crucial insight to internalize. Whatever you're doing, stop thinking, stop doing, get feedback, and refine your offer. And now you may be thinking, well, how can I make this actionable? How can I make this useful to my life? What if I'm not trying to test something within my company, but I'm actually trying to test my life? I don't know where I'm going. I don't know if my decision for my business or my career is actually the one that I want to follow. Well, this still applies. The best thing we've found and we teach for iterating and hypothesizing a meaningful life is commit to a 90-day goal. Something that pushes you outside of your circle of competence, let's say it's here, so you need to push outside and create a new version of yourself that actually helps you grow. This is obviously not enough, because the most important thing here is the systems that you set up, the systems that help you get to that goal. What are all the necessary processes on your personal and your professional life that will eventually get you to where you've never been before, outside of that circle of competence, right? Hopefully this makes sense. The point is that if you've already been where you're trying to go, then you haven't been going far enough. And in order to get far enough, you won't get there by reading books or reading other people's experiences. You're gonna get there by trying, testing, refining, hypothesizing, iterating on each one of your processes, both personal and professional, right? It was a little bit more intellectual, but I strongly believe that this is an important message, because too many people are lost in rumination, which is this tendency to overthink stuff, and not that many are actually in the field of play, working their asses off, getting feedback, iterating, and getting to that next level. Right? And this is one of the core parts of the Submaster Revolution program. We teach people how to fish. So we change the way they think of themselves, of the universe, of the life, or the businesses by using complexity science. And we help them set hypothesis, test hypothesis, refine it. And this is how they get that crazy growth, right? So again, if you want a proven framework, you want to learn how to do this, you really want to get to a whole new level by using a whole new level of thinking that fosters a whole new level of doing, so no bullshit here, we're actually gonna go very hard onto the doing thing, sign up for the program, apply to the program, let's see if we can help you, let's take your business to the next level, your career to the next level. And I hope, in any case, that this was useful. And of course, subscribe, like, comment, do all those things you guys need to do, that we all know you need to do, so that this channel keeps growing, we keep helping more people. And if you have any doubt whatsoever, put it in the comments, let me know what you're struggling with, and the next video will be about your problems. See you in the next one.